So why aren't our cities filled with more buildings as striking and distinctive as the Sydney Opera House? Well, an easy answer is it is very difficult to realise a complex structure like this. It's also monumentally expensive. Indeed, when the Opera House was finished construction in 1973, it was over schedule by 10 whole years and over budget by 1,400%. Complexity and expensive construction aside, I think the real reason we don't often see buildings of this power and magnitude today is because they are always the product of a singular vision. We need to talk about Danish architect Jørn Utzon. In 1957, Jørn Utzon's design for the Sydney Opera House was recognised for its individuality and its futuristic form. It was the power of Jørn Utzon's design that was chosen from among over 230 proposals from architects in more than 30 countries. Jørn's idea, inspired by nature, in fact, the Opera House shells are literally very shell-like, cut through all the other proposed ideas. The complex forms and bespoke structures that make up the Sydney Opera House were an engineering challenge. And the problem the engineers had to wrestle with was to realise the scale of Jørn's incredible vision. Danish architect Jørn Utzon was criticised for having such a complex vision. But if it wasn't for the power of that vision, the engineers, who like to wrestle with problems, they wouldn't have a problem to wrestle with. So Jørn was a man of singular vision. But men of singular vision don't always play nicely with the status quo. Yes, so when construction began this great building, the architect Jørn Utzon could have been forgiven for thinking he no longer had to compete with his peers. After all, it was his award-winning design that was chosen from among those 230 proposals from architects in 30 countries. But, and I believe this strongly, if you have a strong idea, you rarely get to compete with your peers. You rarely get to compete with your equals, people who have equally strong ideas. No, who Jørn Utzon had to compete with once construction started were the bean counters, the small-minded people, the people in government who used the challenges, the cost overruns of building such a magnificent structure to politically advance themselves and to criticise the man and his vision as somehow irresponsible. Which is quite frankly bullshit, because what happened later on in the construction of the building is very telling. Utzon sadly had become fed up with the disputes over fees and cost overruns, and sadly he left the project in 1966, which was 7 years before the completion of the Sydney Opera House in 1973. He went back to Europe, he went back to Denmark. So he did not enjoy the fruits of his labour when the building was finally open. But what's revealing to me is all his critics used his absence to gut his designs for the interior of the building, where performances are held in the Opera House. And it was their small-mindedness that blew the costs out even higher when they wanted to do it their way, rather than honour the vision of the great man who created this building.